are sharing with you is unity by love. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Unity by love. What is love? You have been hearing love. What is love? To the married, to the singles, I want you to understand that there is real love, true love, agape love, God's type of love. And there is also, on the other hand, a cheap love. Cheap love. Somebody call it cheating. Cheap love, something that is temporal, something that doesn't last, something that is, you know, because of what I want to get from you. I love you. After you get that thing, I hate you. I don't know you. In fact, some people in their heart will say, I want to kill you. I want you to get out of my life. What is love? Galatians chapter 5. The Holy Spirit talks about the fruit of the Spirit. And this fruit began with love. Praise the Lord. Yeah. Love is the tree that gives birth to peace. It gives birth to other 8 fruit of the Spirit. Glory be to God.
Amen.
When we look at 1 Corinthians chapter 13, the Holy Spirit taught us what love is. Now, I want you to visualize love as a personality. I want you to visualize unity as a personality. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want to borrow 2 people. Please, Pastor Andrew and your beautiful wife, please, can I borrow you? Please put your hands together for this couple. I see love and unity as twin brothers. One cannot do without the other. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This is love. This is unity. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Love from the scriptures suffers long. Love is kind. Love is gentle. Love does not puff up. Love is not proud. Love is easy to be entreated. Love lasting for long. Love doesn't fail. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But unity, what is the mission of unity in marriage? By my definition, unity is one mind, one voice, and one goal. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So you can imagine a whole, you can imagine a marriage that these 2 personalities are present. Look at the story of the upper room when 120 people gathered. The Holy Spirit, they saw these personalities in their midst. They will see love. They will see unity. And it was easy for the Holy Spirit to visit them. Glory be to God.
Yeah.
I want to encourage you, husbands and wives, make sure you go with these 2 personalities today. Check the type of love you have for your husband or you have for your wife. The type of love you have for your husband or wife, does it suffer or short suffering? You cannot bear it. You cannot take it. How long will I take it for? I cannot continue like this forever. And you begin to know. You begin to complain. In fact, there is no love in that marriage anymore. When there is no love, unity cannot be present. When there is love, love gives birth to unity. Glory be to God.
Amen.
In what areas of marriage are we looking or are we expecting unity to speak? For example, in your walk with God, let's look at this. A husband and a wife, they are believers. And God is calling a woman into a ministry. And the husband is saying, excuse me, if God is going to use anybody in this family, it must be me, the wife, because I am the head of this house. They got it all wrong.
Right, yeah.
The Bible said that in Christ Jesus, there is no male, there is no female.
Right.
And I tell you, as I have told the world years ago, that you don't be too familiar with Jesus.
That's right.
To tell him who and who he should use.
That's right.
To do what in his body. That is a foolish familiarity.
That's right.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
When God sees the heart of your wife and he chooses to use your wife, where there is love, there will be an agreement.
That's right.
There will be unity in that point to support your wife. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Because generally you see that there's always men of God and women of God that are relegated to the background. Do you know what? Good news. God is choosing and raising up women. God is using radical women.
Glory!
Glory be to God.
Preachers.
And I tell you, men should not complain.
That's right.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So men are looking at me very well. Look at me very well. I repeat myself. I like Joyce Meyer.
Oh my God.
My sister. Do you know they interviewed both of them, Joyce and Dave? And David said that he thanked the Lord for choosing his wife.
Yeah.
He did not compete with his wife. In fact, it's Joyce Meyer's first being. You know, he said he thanked the Lord for choosing his wife. Why his wife? When there are other women out there. So he seen that as a great honor.
Hallelujah.
That it wasn't him but his wife.
That's right.
That is love and unity.
Yeah.
And we see them always backing Joyce up.
That
is how it should be.
That's right.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In other homes, when the wife that is called say, honey, I've got a ministration on Wednesday in his presence, Christ talked about that book, and the husband will say, you are not going anywhere. You are not going anywhere. You said God has called you, but I am the head of the home, and I'm telling you, you are not going anywhere. Well, the woman will say, oh God, what is this? What have I done? Well, you have married this man. You are not supposed to marry, but you married him. So you face the consequence until God delivers you. Until God plants in the heart of your husband the type of love I have presented to you today. Praise the Lord. Somebody called me this morning with that problem. I said, well, I'm a sister, you will have to continue to pray. I pray until something happens. You cannot divorce, you cannot run away from that marriage because your husband refuses to serve the Lord. There are some marriages who are not meant to be. What God has joined together, let no man. How are you sure it was God that joined you together? Some marriages, when they were before the end of the world, when these people, when they were before the man of God, they deceived him. They deceived the man of God, joining them together. And that man of God himself did not pray to see that God is not here. Back then, at the altar, heaven back then, heaven is against them. So not all marriages are joined by God. Some marriages joined by themselves. Some marriages, people join them together. So when they are in deep waters, these people who join them together. Praise the Lord. That is why this school of marriage is very, very important for you, especially if you are still single. So that you don't fall into the errors, the marriage of today failing, and they are crying out for help today. Praise the Lord. Another area where unity, love should powerfully speak in marriage, the area of decision making and decision taking. When there is love, when there is unity, there will be harmony. It will be easy to agree with one another concerning a decision, whether about your relationship, a decision about raising up your children. Praise the Lord. In some marriages where there is no love, where there is no unity, and the children are seeing all this, they will go to dad, say, dad, I want this, I want this. Dad will say no. Well, he said, okay, it's you that says so. Let me go to mom. Mom, I want the best now. So there is division. So the children sing this, helps to promote the mission.
That's right.
In that realm. Praise the Lord. Another area is the issue of money. Praise the Lord. It is in the world today, we see a wife with separate account. The husband, separate account. Both of them, they are trying to protect their future. They are saying the way, in case this marriage fails, I need to take care of myself. I need to make sure that I have enough money. Praise the Lord. You see some wives, they are building houses in Lagos. The husband is not aware. Because they are thinking, well, if this fire collapses today, at least I will have roof over my head. They are selfish. They are love and unity is happening. They are selfish. They don't think about the husband. They only think about themselves. Praise God. For 7 years, the man of